MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball brings us to the great state of Florida and Marlins Park in Miami. Tonight, the finale of this four-game set between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Miami Marlins. McCutchen and Arenado lead their teams coming up next. Jared Cozart, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound here. What's your take on him, EK?
Well, guys, one of the anomalies of this season, he has just not pitched well at home. Really struggled all season long.
Starling Marte strides forward, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
For Pittsburgh, left fielder, Starling Marte.
And a swing and a miss, so a first pitch strike as we're underway here this evening. This Marlin ball club, Eric Karros, as they begin play here tonight, they've been in a nice little groove of winning three of their last four games.
And it's been a back and forth series so far, but they have been able to take two of the first three. So it's going to be up to that man on the mound to see if they can get out of here winning three of four.
Cozart's ready. Here's the 0-2. That misses, one and two. 73 degrees our game time temperature here tonight, and it probably won't get a whole lot cooler than that. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Ready on one and two. To two balls and two strikes now. Grounded back up the middle. And this goes right through him. And how about that to start a game?
Yeah, a nice job there as this one gets right up the middle to start the ball game. Always nice to put a guy in the stretch right from the very start.
Josh Harrison will stand in now, and as you take a look at the splits, his numbers compare unfavorably once he leaves the comforts of home. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what, if he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, Matt, the pitcher may have thought the runner might be on the move right there, so he slide steps to hang on to him.
And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Working the plate is Larry Bullard.
Yeah, Bullard's got a pretty good strike zone all around. He'll miss a call every once in a while in the corners, but what umpire doesn't?
Nobody out, runner on first. And perhaps sensing a hit and run may be on, a move to first. And he's back standing. And again a throw and a dive, but he's back in.
Got a pretty good lead right there.
Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
You get the leadoff single, and now you got a 3-1 count. He's already in a little hot water here to start the ball game.
Here it is on 3-1. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while, and when he does, you can forget it.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. To Gordon for one. On to first, a double play. And here's Kuhn Hertl's starting lineup for the Pirates in this one.
What's the key for them if they want to split this series, Steve?
Well, Matt, this team has elite speed, so all you have to do is keep the ball on the ground, focus on hitting line drives, and play small ball.
Andrew McCutchen will come on now, and no sooner did it look like they may have something started than the double play took it all away.
And that's especially tough when you figure the part of the lineup they're in. These are the guys you want to have hitting with runners on base.
He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. And this winds up inside for a ball. 2-0 now. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
Just starting things out here in South Florida. 3-0 now. At the very least, he certainly established the inside part of the plate.
Yeah, but it's not going to do him a whole lot of good if none of those can find the strike zone.
And oh, he thought that was ball four, but it's called a strike. 3-1 now.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. McCutchen will take one that misses. It's ball four.
Batting fourth, third baseman,
Jung-ho Gong will get his first opportunity here, and that average is certainly not where he wants it, down in the 220s to begin the ball game.
Hey, you never know. Things might be looking up for this guy. He's hitting over 300 in his last 10 games, even though his season average doesn't look that good.
Here's the first pitch to him. Nope. Low for ball one. Just missing here, 2-0.
Just getting deeper and deeper into trouble here in the first inning. He's walked one guy already. Now he's fallen behind another guy here.
Too high, and it's 3-0.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at bat, because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
He's set. Here's the 3-0.
Yeah.
That one's in there. 3-1.
Yeah, taken all the way right there. You better be taking 3-0 after he walked the previous guy.
Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. Drilled right back up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
A good job here. Stays inside the ball well, doesn't roll over, and just shoots his ball right back up the middle.
Standing in now, Francisco Cervelli, as he'll take a look at ball one.
Well, this is the kind of situation where they came up short last night. They had opportunities, but they could never really cash them in, so you can bet they'd love to get something going on the board early here.
Trying to escape unscathed here in the first. High in the air and deep to straightaway left. See you later. Over the wall, a home run.
It's
So a three-run blast to straightaway left, eighth home run on the season for him. And the lead for the Pirates is now 3-0.
Well, he worked himself into trouble out there right off the bat. He had to go through the heart of the order with guys on base. And now the next thing you know, he's already down 3-0 before he gets out of the first.
Batting six.
Stepping in now, Jason Rogers.
Jason Rogers.
As he'll line this one foul to the right side out of play, it's strike one. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And nope, this one falls, so he'll get another shot. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Grounded to third. Oh, look at Clotto. He's up with it. The throw. It's there. He got him.
Wow. Made it look easy.
They call it the hot corner for a reason. And this is a beauty to take us to break. More to come from Marlins Park right after this. Ryan Vogelsong, a right-hander from North Carolina, is the man on the mound. What do you have for us on him, EK?
Well, guys, he's having a real consistent year. He's got an ERA under 3. Anytime you're doing something like that, you're doing just fine.
D. Gordon comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half
leading
of the first.
The second baseman, D. Gordon.
And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one. Eric, we look at this Pirate ball club as they enter play here tonight. They come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped 5 of their last 8 ball games.
And with the loss yesterday, that means they've dropped 2 of the first 3 in this series. So if form holds, they're due to come back and win this one, and they'll end up splitting the series.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. 1-2 pitch is a curveball that misses 2-2. Still 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. And a sliding effort there, but that ball had eyes and the leadoff man's on base to start the inning.
Batting second, left fielder.
Striding into the box, Marcelo Zuna, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. And that's in there for his strike 1-1. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. In the dirt here. And they got him. Boy, his feet were stuck in the mud there. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. Justin Bohr will be next. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Batting third, first baseman,
Justin Bohr will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. can't get around quick enough, and that'll move the count to 1-1. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. The 2-2 pitch. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
Lifted the other way out to left center. After it is McCutchen. Two gone. Time now for a glance at the Marlins lineup card in this one. EK, any thoughts?
Well, Matt, I'm going to be watching the speedster, D. Gordon. He's a top talent when it comes to speed, and so far this year he leads the senior circuit in stolen bases. Look for him to make an impact on this game with his legs.
Giancarlo Stanton will get his first opportunity here, currently leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories.
He's having just a great season, but it's so hard to lead all three categories. He's not even in the top five in average.
A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. A runner on first with two away. Two and oh.
Well, one of the real strengths of his game is that he's not going to go after a whole lot of bad pitches out of the strike zone. So he's a guy that's going to make you earn it by only swinging at strikes.
Two and oh pitch on the way. Outside, 3-0 now. Martin Prado would be next. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. Hit out of play, and it's a full count now. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll go on to the top of inning number two. It's the Pirates 3 and the Marlins nothing. Pedro Florimon will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Cozart into the windup. First pitch on its way. Right there for strike one. Down the first baseline. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second. With a moment now, let's give you a look at the Miami D. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, Giancarlo Stanton, if you've ever had an opportunity to watch him take BP, go watch it because it is unreal. Defensively, you can watch that as well. He's got a very good arm, and he shows surprising athletic ability for a big man out there. We'll see what he does in this one.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Kyle Saul comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. called strike two on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2.
And you kind of wonder if he's learned anything out there. There's another pitch right down the middle, and I think he's lucky that that one didn't get hit a long way.
The 1-2 pitch. On the ground near home, Realmuto is up with it. Crow gets him, two down.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, number 14. Ryan
at the
plate,
Ryan Vogelsong. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And the first pitch to the 38-year-old veteran is in for a called strike, nothing and one.
Well, much, much better here in the second inning. To me, he looked a little bit tentative early on. It's starting to look like he's finding the rhythm now.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, and it's tough enough to hit 95-plus mile-an-hour fastballs. That curve gives you something else to think about altogether.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Pirates, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Martin Prado will stand in, and you see what he's done over the past four games, as hot as they come.
Third baseman, Martin Prado.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
Well, you got to figure that this guy's going to come out here free and easy here in the second. He's got a three-run cushion already. No reason not to come right after these guys.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good fastball hitter. You don't want to give in to his strength.
Two balls and a strike. Here it is. A swing, and it's popped in the air back behind first. Rodgers is over, and he puts it away for the first down. Now that we have a chance, let's give you a look at how the Pirates align defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric?
Well, guys, we have an opportunity to watch Andrew McCutchen out there in that outfield. Man, he can play. Does a lot of things defensively, can go get the ball, covers a lot of ground, and has a pretty darn good throwing arm as well.
JT Realmuto will stand in now, still struggling to get anything going offensively.
Well, his batting average is ugly, and his last 10 games have been ugly. Just two hits in his last 10.
Too high, 1-0. High fly ball out to straightaway center. McCutchen is under it, and he makes the catch for the second out.
Batting seventh, center fielder,
Cole Gillespie gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. First delivery to him on the way. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
A little bit of hang time there to that curveball. I don't think that's exactly where he's going to want to throw that pitch going forward. It worked out right there, but he better find a little extra snap on that pitch in the future.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a liner, but a foul ball. Now the 0-2 pitch. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. And now a swing and a ball hit hard back up the middle. And that'll get down for a two-out single.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right on that.
Miguel Rojas will stride forward now, looking to keep that hit streak alive. Currently at 6 games entering play. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike.
You see right there on the graphic, these first two innings have been costly pitch-wise. He's at 35 already, and he's only through an inning and two-thirds.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Outside, 2-1.
All right, now you've just seen two straight breaking pitches miss away. So as a hitter, you're going to eliminate that pitch. No way does he throw it a third time.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch bounced weakly near the plate. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Marlins leave one. They trail it here 3-0. Starling Marte is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
And you know, guys, I love a guy like this leading off an inning for you. He makes good contact and he can run.
First pitch is a cutter looked at 0-1. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. You've got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine, but you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. High in the air and deep to left center field. Ozuna looks up. Gone! It's a solo shot for Starling Marte. Home run number 9 on the year as the Pirates have opened it up now 4-0.
And this is one of those guys that we consider to be part of that new breed of leadoff hitter. You know, it used to be that your leadoff guy was a guy that might hit 3 or 4 home runs a year. But nowadays, managers are realizing, hey, my leadoff guy is going to get more at-bats than anyone else in my lineup over the course of the season. So why not put a better hitter up there rather than just a punch and Judy guy? And that certainly worked out for him right here.
Josh Harrison stands in.
Second baseman, Josh.
As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Now you start to worry that maybe this already has the makings of a short outing.
And that's not what that man right there wants to hear. He'd hate to have to make a change this early, but he might have to.
Cozart has his sign. 1-0 on its way. Left it up in the zone, but it's a strike. 1-1. A lot of pitches up in the zone here early on.
And that's not the worst thing in the world at this place, but you've got to pick your spots.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he's retired, one away.
Now batting number 22, center fielder Andrew McCutcheon.
Andrew McCutcheon digs in with one run in and one gone in the inning. First pitch coming, here it is. And a ball, 1-0.
And these guys already have one home run here in the inning, and now you get to the real power guys here. So you need to be careful.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball at 96 on the radar gun, and it's 1-1. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Jammed him a bit there as it's fouled at the plate. Hit hard on the ground at third. Prado was there. Now a low throw, but he can't knock it down at first as it gets right by him.
Well, when you're making that throw across a diamond, you don't get a lot on it. Get on top of it, it's going to sink. And I think he just tried to finesse that one a bit too much, and they'll hit him with an E5.
Into the box, Jung Ho Gong, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. Swing and a liner. Foul. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. In the dirt. And he is safe at second base as the decision to move up pays off, and that'll likely be scored a wild pitch.
And you wonder if sometimes he was just getting a little too preoccupied out there with the speed at first base. And he totally loses focus on the guy at the plate. And now that essentially is going to work like a stolen base, and he's in the scoring position now on the wild pitch.
A ball and two strikes. Here it is. Ball two. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch.
The count is full.
Full count, 3-2. A lot of deep counts for these guys early on.
And the more the better as far as they're concerned. They'd like to get him out of here as quick as they can.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Now a swing and a fly ball. Stanton on the run. And that's the second out of the inning. Francisco Cervelli stands in another RBI spot. He's already got three in the game. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. In there, strike one.
Corner paint right there, 97 miles an hour. What are you going to do with that?
Takes a pitch high and away for ball one. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And another foul ball. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Oh, and he gets a hold of this one as it's in the air to deep left. Does he have another one? He does. It's another home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. His second home run of the game. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
Boy, that guy on the mound right now is absolutely livid. He knows that he threw way too hittable of a pitch in the situation when he's ahead in the count like that. He should be mad at himself.
Into the box now, Jason Rogers. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. Seems like they're showing a lot of faith in this guy, leaving him out there.
And I think you appreciate that as a pitcher, but sometimes when you don't have it, you don't have it. It looks like this is going to be one of those times.
Oh, good spot. On the black for strike two.
Two pitches right on the outside corner. If he's going to keep looking at him, they might as well just stay out there. Why not?
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. Pittsburgh leads this one 6-0. Adani Echevarria will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number three, Adani Echevarria.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
And that guy right there is the beneficiary of all these early runs. He's got to be the happiest guy in the ballpark.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
And little doubt about that one. That's in there, and it's 2-1.
And at the plate, if you've got an umpire helping you out, no reason to go after a borderline pitch on 2-0.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
And boy, this is exactly how you want your leadoff hitter to approach an at-bat. He's showing a lot of patience, and it's worked out so far.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Saul giving chase, and a dive, but he can't pull it in out in right center.
Well, you know, you hear us talk ad nauseum about working the count, getting yourself in the fastball count. But we do it for a good reason. Here he does exactly that. He works at the 3-1. He's going to sit dead red here, and then he jumps all over it. And when you make good decisions at the plate, the game can actually become pretty simple sometimes. Oh, my gosh, did I just say that?
Here's D. Gordon now. That's lifted the other way out to left. Marte's after it. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And a daring move there pays off as he'll make it into third on the fly ball to left.
So a double and a fly ball move a man to third now with one away. Now if they could just get another fly ball, it would likely net him a run.
Digging in to try it again, Marcell Ozuna. He drew a walk his first time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Drilled on the ground to short. Florimon gloves it. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
Yeah, and unless he was going on his own down there at third, they were using that contact play where you're told wherever and whenever the ball's hit, you're off and running. You're not even paying attention to what's going on. You've got to go. They love to play an aggressive style on the bases, and it gets them a run right there.
Standing in now, Justin Bour. As he swings at the first pitch and sends a chopper out to short. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So one run on one hit, no errors, and no one left on base. Three innings complete. Bucks out in front, 6-1. David Phelps is going to come on and make an appearance here, though I suspect even he couldn't have predicted he'd be taking over in just the fourth inning. Now to the plate, Pedro Florimond. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Pedro Florimond.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Yeah, same pitch, same result, and he's late on it again.
Got him.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes. Because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch him out.
In now, Kyle Saul. As he'll come up empty there as he misses the off-speed pitch for strike one.
That is the hardest first pitch to look for because you just can't wait long enough. Not only is it a hard pitch to hit, but it sets up everything else you have.
Yeah. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Well, you know, when you're behind an account like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. A little low, it's 2-2.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
Six runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Well, that pitch is so low and such an easy take that you basically waste that opportunity you had on 2-2.
And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
The pitcher, number 14, Ryan Vogelsong.
Ryan Vogelsong comes to the plate, possibly receiving a bunt sign in order to stay out of the double play.
Yeah, and everybody's got a different opinion on this situation. But in reality, it really comes down to how the pitcher is with the bat in his hands and what he can do.
Showing bunt here, but he takes ball one.
And you know, I've always thought, if you're pretty sure a guy might be trying to bunt, then put that first pitch out of the strike zone. Make him show you his intentions. Maybe you get him to offer it something that he shouldn't.
And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. To second for one, relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. The dangerous Giancarlo Stanton will get the first shot when we return. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. Pirates lead it 6-1. And there now is Giancarlo Stanton. He'll try and do what he can to work toward cutting into this big deficit.
Maybe a leadoff base runner could get them going and give them a chance. They need to start making a move if they have any hope of getting back in this one.
and he falls behind now 2-0.
After the strikeout his first time around, I think he was able to use that first at bat as a learning experience. Those have both been real good takes.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Cervelli should have room and a rather easy first out.
Third baseman number 14, Martin Prado.
Martin Prado is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. Into the windup and the pitch. And he gets ahead with the curveball. Strike one. Ripped on the ground to first. Rogers fields it cleanly, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Now batting, catcher, J.T. Realmuto.
Now at the plate, J.T. Realmuto. He flew out in his last at-bat. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And the count will be full. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Rocket to third. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Yeah, a nice effort here at third. It gets on him pretty quickly. Maybe if he's a foot taller, he's got a shot, but this one had left field written all over it.
Stepping in now, Cole Gillespie. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Two out with the man at first. Swung on and hit deep to left center. McCutcheon going back, but he won't get there as it lands just shy of the wall. And a relay to the plate is in time, and he's cut down at the plate as they team up to gun him down.
Hold.
One left for Miami. They trail 6-1. Starling Marte heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Dribbled back toward the mound. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The batter, second baseman, Josh Harrison.
At the plate, Josh Harrison. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, his swing definitely broke down a little bit last time. He got way underneath the ball. It'll be interesting to see if he can make that adjustment and stay on top of the ball here.
And he'll lay off a fastball here in a good spot, but ruled the ball 1-0. That's wide, 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
left field and deep. Back goes Ozuna to the track, to the wall. Gone! A solo shot here to left, as it's now a 6-run ball game.
Well, when you start relying on one pitch out there, and you become a one-pitch pitcher, there's no doubt in the hitter's mind what's coming. He's sitting on this one all the way, and he launches it right over the wall.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. 7 runs, just 6 hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. Here's another one that's drilled, this one to left. Ozuna ranging back. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
Now batting,
Jung Ho Kang will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in 2 trips thus far.
And you know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first 2 at-bats. He seems to be seeing the ball well and putting some decent swings on it.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Changeup stays outside and is behind 2-0.
And this is what you got to do up there, Steve. You got to wait him out.
Yeah, and if you can lay off the off-speed stuff, that's when you're going to get your fastball to hit.
Too tight with that one. 3-0. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. Changeup inside. They lost him. Ball 4.
Now batting, catcher, Francisco Cervelli.
Francisco Cervelli stands in again here with 2 home runs already to his name in this one.
And you know what, Matt? He's just made it look so easy out there. I think they've got to change their approach right here. Use some caution or something.
Watches a fastball right there for strike 1. A runner on first with 2 away. And he watches a called strike at the knees. No balls and 2 strikes.
No taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
And he wastes a fastball high there, 1-2.
That man's got to be thinking, enough with the walks. Can't anybody throw a strike?
Hit down the third baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Pirates tack on one more on the solo home run. Middle of the night here in Miami. It's the Pirates 7 and the Marlins 1. Miguel Rojas comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the 5th.
Well, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
8-9-1 to start the inning as the first pitch misses for ball 1. The pitch count there, 1 pitch into his 5th inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. 2 close pitches, 2 good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
Line to the right side, and that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
7 straight games with a base hit now, and that's a solid week or so of swinging the bat with some authority.
Chris Johnson will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 12, Chris Johnson.
First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. That's inside, 2-0. Both teams with six hits so far. Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1. 2-1, here it is. Now a slider misses, and that pushes the count to 3-1.
This is a good fastball spot for him now, and keep in mind, he's got a big hole on that right side of the infield.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2. It seems like we've seen a lot of guys late on the fastball tonight.
And he's not throwing all that hard either, but when he throws it off the other pitches, that's where it makes it a little more difficult.
Full count, here it comes. Good swing just a little early, and he'll see another payoff pitch. Ready now with the payoff pitch. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Wow, talk about a difference that 24 hours makes. Yesterday, these guys were hitting everything in sight, but things sure have changed this time around. They haven't been able to get anything going at all.
D. Gordon steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Fastball misses inside. It's even at 1. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And this one's in the dirt, but fortunately here, no advance. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Marte is under it. Two down. Marcell Ozuna strides in, grounded out his last time through.
Ozuna.
Here comes the first pitch. And he lays off there, 1-0.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
Downstairs, two balls and no strikes. Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike, 2-1.
And this offense has just been stuck in neutral. Even when they get a guy on to start the inning, they've got nothing to go with it.
Ready with two balls and a strike. Pulled high in the air out to left field. And Marte will make the grab, and that ends the inning. Marlins leave one. They're down 7-1. Brian Morris will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Jason Rogers will make his way in as he leads things off here in the Pirates' half of the sixth.
First baseman, Jason Rogers.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. A high strike there, and it's 1-1. And the 1-1 is in the air now out to center. Gillespie is in pursuit. He's got it one away. Pedro Florimon will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
Fastball in there for a called strike. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. A pause, and the 0-2. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Right side. A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit.
And here's where, on the mound, you got to tell yourself, you did everything right there. This was an 0-2 pitch, and he did a great job of getting him to hit it on the ground. Just happens to find a hole on the right side. I mean, what are you going to do?
Now a move over to first. Runner back safely.
Why not? Make him get dirty.
Into the box now, Kyle Saul.
Nope.
And that misses for ball one. Runner at first here, one man out. Two and oh now. Hit the other way out toward right field. Under it now is Stanton to make the catch, and there are two away now. Ryan Vogelsong stands into the box. He's 0 for 2 so far in this one. First pitch on its way, and he gets ahead 0-1. Two out with the man at first. Goodness, 0-2 now.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
Here's the 0-2. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Pirates leave one. They're on top 7-1. Justin Bohr will try it again. 0-2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far.
Well, guys, if you split the difference between the fly ball and the grounder he's put in play, you've got a nice line drive. So maybe we'll witness that right here.
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And taken in out there for the first out.
The right fielder, number 27. Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in. He struck out and popped out in two trips.
Well, not a great start at the plate. We'll see if he can get something to drive right here.
Out in front of it, strike one. One out, nobody on. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but
as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
This is line to left. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Oh, and this ball center cut right here. Got it right on the barrel. He just drills it into left field for a one-out single.
Martin Prado will stand in for the third time now. Still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
In there, no balls and a strike.
And you know, whenever he's been in trouble on the mound, he's found a way to turn things around, and that's a good job to start this guy with strike one.
The 0-1. And he lays off for ball one.
I got a ball, one strike.
One and two.
One ball, two strike.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Marte moves over. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. JT Realmuto will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. First offering on its way. Hit in the air out to right. Saul has a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. One left for Miami. They're down 7-1. Welcome back to South Florida. It's on to the seventh inning with the Pirates leading in this one, but before the inning gets underway, let's check out the game summary to this point. Carter Capps will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Starling Marte will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. And that's in there for strike one.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Stanton sprinting after it, and foul.
Nope.
And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off. One and two.
All right, so he sort of wasted one up right there. Now I think we'll see a breaking ball down in the zone trying to get him to swing and miss.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Late making contact on that swing, and we'll do it again on 1-2. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Lays off 2-2 now.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. Well, that was inside. Close to triple digits. He didn't even flinch.
And And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy out, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Josh Harrison will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. He's set. Here it comes. Chopped foul over towards the dugout. A shot down the first baseline. Gets dirty and gloves it. It's in time.
Oh, what a play.
Boy, that's really a great play here at first. This ball has double written all over it, but that's a great job there to lay himself out and then hustle over to the bag to get the three unassisted put out.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Two out, nobody on. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's one and one.
You want to talk about a live arm? This guy's got one, all right.
A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's one and two. To short, hit hard. Rojas has it. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Pirates. They're on top 7-1. Leading off the inning, Cole Gillespie. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, you're facing a pretty big deficit in this game, so they need to start clawing their way back.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Fastball. Nope. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
He did not like that one bit. Now, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff, but don't do it around the dome.
Fastball not close, and he runs it to two balls and a strike.
Yeah, he seems to be pitching him a little cautiously here. Maybe it's because he's 2-for-2 against him so far, but I think this is a guy you still need to come right after.
And the pitch on 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches. He probably doesn't have a whole lot left in the tank, so the more you make him work, the better your chances of getting a mistake.
And that one is a called strike as he's rebounded to run it full now, 3-2. Line drive to left and a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Well, you've got a big lead out there on the mound, so on 3-2, it's challenge time. He comes with the good fastball here, but this ball gets turned around for a solid single. That's all right, though. Better that than walking.
Miguel Rojas will dig in. 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. Down and away, one ball and no strikes. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. A runner at first with no outs here. And this is just off the outside corner, ball two.
And you can tell he's starting to get a little jumpy out there. He's got to take his time and really focus in on the glove.
Scorched to third. Taken in by Gunn. There's Harrison for one. On to first, and they get them both.
The pitcher, number 22, Carter.
Derek Dietrich will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty.
Dietrich.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. EK, the starter, creeping up on 100 pitches now, but that number alone doesn't appear to be affecting him too much at all.
Yeah, he still looks sharp. Still, with the way the teams handle pitchers nowadays, I don't think he'll wind up going much further.
Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. McCutcheon has it in his sights, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Nothing doing for the Marlins. They're down 7-1. Mike Dunn will come on now in a mop-up role, as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Jung Ho Kang steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. On to the eighth now, as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Driven down the left field line. Will it stay fair? It will, just to the right of the chalk of fair ball. And he's able to hustle his way up to second, as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Pretty safe to say he was sitting on the fastball there. He's out in front of this pitch, and he just drills it right down the line. And that'll put him in a good position here with the runner on second and nobody out.
Francisco Cervelli will stand in again, as we flash you back to the early stages of this ball game. There were fans still finding their seats as he launched his second home run of the game, as he was off to a fast start indeed. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch.
Yeah.
And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control, 0-2.
Yeah, that pitch is still up a little bit, but at least this one was out on a corner. But I don't think I'd want to be making a living up there too much.
The 0-2 pitch. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate.
I'll say this, he wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
And a fastball swung on and missed, as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Well, if you're going to be a relief pitcher in this league, you better have a little bit of fearlessness in you, because this guy's already got two home runs earlier in the game. And look what he does. He comes right back after him in this at-bat, and it winds up paying off.
Standing in now, Jason Rogers, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. Both teams with 8 hits in this one. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
And now with a 2-0 count, both pitches have been in. This might be where you say, all right, I'm going to let it fly if this next one's middle away.
Ready with the 2-0 pitch. And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. To 2-2 now.
Yeah, the velocity's good here, but I'm not so sure about the location. That was right down the middle.
One out and a runner on second base. Tough fastball that time, but he hangs with it to stay alive. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Two and two count. Here it comes. High in the air out to center field. Gillespie has a play. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Pedro Florimon gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in 3 tries to this point. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Here's the 1-1. Here's a high pop-up. Prado is there for it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One left for Pittsburgh. They're on top 7-1. And Clint Hurdle's out to have a conference at home plate, so it appears we'll see a double switch here. Tony Watson will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here.
Number 44, Tony Watson. Now playing shortstop and batting in the ninth spot.
Leading off the inning, D. Gordon, and they'll need him to get something going here.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Well, you've got the matchup you wanted, but that's not going to amount to much if he can't throw strikes.
Hitters count. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Lifted the other way to left center. McCutcheon on the move. But he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
Matt, at bat right there, that's exactly why this guy's such a tough out. I mean, he's not going to launch too many balls into the stands, but he will do this. And that's work the count in his favor and then come through with a solid single.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Smoked on the ground left side. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit.
Yeah, that was always going to be a tough play right there. This gets on him so quick. If he finds a way to snare it, then it's going to be a double play. Instead, they've got something going now with two men on.
Justin Bour will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Yeah, guys, he's got to be feeling a little bit like that dog that gets left out in the rain while the rest of the family's inside by the fire. I guess he's just not seeing what everyone else is.
You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. First and second here with nobody out. One 0 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed, one and one.
Gotta like the approach right here. He's basically saying, if you're gonna beat me, you're gonna have to take it to left field, because I don't think he's gonna give this guy anything he can pull.
One and one, here it comes. On the ground is short. This could be two. One there. And boy, just about overshot his man at first, but he's able to keep a foot on the bag over there, and that's out number two.
Well, there's the pitcher's best friend right there. You know, nothing gets you off the hook after back-to-back singles, quite like a double play ball to that third guy.
Giancarlo Stanton now, as he'll take a changeup here for strike one.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
Men on third with two down. And that finds the target, nothing in two now.
And this would be a great escape if he could strand that runner at third after those back-to-back singles to start things off.
Ready on 0-2. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Marlins leave one. They're down 7-1. Always a party in Miami Beach, not too far from us here at Marlins Park, set to begin the ninth inning in this one. Brad Hand will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Kyle Saul will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Right fielder, Kyle Saul.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Fastball runs off the outside. It's 1-1. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Ozuna on the move, but this will land foul just shy of the wall. And the pitch. Hit high in the air down the right field line. On the move is Stanton. One out.
Now batting.
Jordy Mercer stands in for the first time. First pitch here is another fly ball. This one out to left field. Under it is Ozuna, and there are two gone now.
Now batting, left fielder, Starling Marte.
Starling Marte is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the third inning. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. up the middle and off his leg. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. Josh Harrison is into the box now. He hit one over the wall back in the fifth. Curveball looked at here for strike one.
Not a bad idea to take a look at that one there. Now that you've seen the curveball, you can start to get a better gauge on it, get a feel for what it looks like coming out of the pitcher's hand.
Now a snap move over to first. Just keeping him close.
Just keeping an eye on him.
A runner on first with two away. And another snap throw to the bag. Keeping particularly close tabs on him.
Definitely has his attention.
Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
This is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit, 1-2.
That big curveball is not an easy one to take on an 0-2 count. That's a great job of holding off.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Stanton coming on. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
And this is when you know the stars are lined up in your favor as a hitter. I mean, look how bunched up he was on that swing, yet he still finds a way to muscle that to right for a double.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0.
Just did manage to catch that one with the last 2 inches of his glove. That could have been trouble.
The 1-0 delivery. That evens it up, 1-1. Second and third, two away. Hard hit ball to second. Gordon is up with it. Throw on to first is in time, and that snuffs out the Bucco rally as the inning is over. Pirates strand a couple. They're on top 7-1. Striding in to start the ninth, Martin Prado, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Third baseman, number 14.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one.
Boy, they've done a really good job against this guy so far, and it's the first time in the series that they've held him without a hit.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. Set and the 2-1 pitch, and he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1.
And that's right where you want to be throwing those sinkers, but he's doing a good job at the plate of not chasing.
Tap fouled at home plate. fly ball out to straightaway right. Saul over to his left, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting, catcher, JT Realmuto.
JT Realmuto will stand in. He flew out his last time up. First pitch of the at-bat. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
Well, these guys sure have been doing a lot of moaning and groaning tonight. He did not like that call at all.
And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Swing and a little tapper. Foul ball, strike two. Now here's the pitch. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. Wow, this one bounces off the pitcher. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. And now they'll hustle out there and attend to their pitcher. And that was quite a shot he took, as you see him down on a knee. But if there's one thing I know about this guy, he will not want to come out of this game. And from all indications, it looks like he's going to try to continue. In now, Cole Gillespie. He's looking to go 4-for-4 with a base hit right here. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now a changeup here to start things out, but that'll dip a bit too low, and it's 1-0. Oh, and he had him guessing there, and it's a ball and a strike.
Now he's probably lucky he didn't make contact on that one.
Here's the 1-1 delivery. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Pitch is popped up. Calling for it. Harrison. He's got it, and there are two down now.
Now batting. Shortstop.
Miguel Rojas gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Comes set. Now the pitch. First pitch is a slider down low. It's 1-0. Chop foul right at home plate. It's strike one. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Another one sent foul. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
And you know what? I don't care who you're playing. You know, it's never easy to go out on the road and win any game. So that was a great effort by them in every phase of the game.
one more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. Well, a pretty good offensive show of force in this one. Probably at least a couple of players deserving. But, gentlemen, let's go ahead and give this man the nod as our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he connected on a couple of long home runs. Really put his guys on his back and carried them to the victory.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Pirates win it 7-1. Good night from Miami.